sliding down your chimney tonight. Broken grotto. Festive floor show. And don't eat the brown snow.
Oh.
Tuck it and see what comes out. It's You've Been Framed Christmas Crackers. Welcome to the show and happy Christmas.
10, 9.
They're counting down to the start of a new You've Been Framed Christmas special.
4, 3, 2, 1.
You okay?
Oh, that was it.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. It's a bit early for that. Thanks. I hate it when the window cleaner turns up on Christmas Day and tries to charge you double time. I normally open the Velux window on the roof.
Well, he's gonna get through!
Go on, clear off! The water in your bucket's frozen solid and your chamois is stiff as a board.
Woo! Good one, Daddy!
I think we've all played the classic Christmas game, cling film, oven gloves, bog roll, wrapping paper, haven't we? You forgot to shout cling film, oven gloves, bog roll, wrapping paper. It's your turn to do the washing up. Someone really needs to speed up the opening mechanism on Santa's warehouse. Will you try getting an engineer to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? I think everyone has at least one day like this over Christmas when we know it's time to stop drinking. Pop star Rag and Bone Man is on his way back from the Chinese takeaway with his Christmas dinner for one. He's only human, but I'm putting the blame firmly on him. Yuck, is that a living room or a set from a 90s sitcom? The plot is straight out of one.
Are you okay?
Hi, honey, I'm home. As if that place wasn't cluttered enough. Music! And for anyone hoping for a white Christmas, here's the next best thing!
I've made mistakes, but so have you. It's been a year of nothing new. And now I'm waiting for this to unfold. There is a class, but I'm outside. I keep my wearing spirits high to you. I'm hoping to meet in the cold. And no, you're not the only reason I came home. And maybe it's the seasons, I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm on my own.
Teenagers now. I mean, most people use a duster to polish the banisters, but not her. A little pledge on her gusset and... Now get the brasso and a stepladder and buff up the door knocker. Not many Christmas decorations in this place, and I'm starting to see why. It's his brother.
Ooh, ah. Ooh, ooh. Oh.
He's a bauble breaker. The song Jingle Bells gives this teenager terrible Vietnam flashbacks.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Not the Vietnam War, obviously, but about Christmas he had there in a treehouse hotel, when it was only 3 stars. Oh, the horror! Don't you hate it when your right hand has an involuntary muscle spasm? Did you mean to do that?
I did not mean to do that.
I thought not. She's opening a present meant for Dad, who then has to furiously improvise.
That's the wrong one. Put it away.
And your excuses?
It was in the bin 11. It was supposed to be the Hogwarts crest, okay?
Yeah, right. CCTV now. And this driver has left his car door open, and the car is catching a chill. Fortunately, Elon Musk has programmed it to look after itself. It's off to the chemist for a hot water bottle and a lens sip. Here she comes.
Ow!
And she's straight on the naughty list. That's not a fisheye lens, by the way. Their porch is actually built like that. All curved and difficult to walk on. Yes, the architect had cataracts. Oh, don't get off your phone, will you?
I can't talk right now. Give me a two.
He's picked a lovely day to put up his Christmas lights, hasn't he? And I don't know about you, but I always find that when going up and down ladders, it's easier to use the side with the steps on. Okay, the other side is quicker. But if you add the time spent waiting in A&E, it's a false economy. The turkey that lives here has heard they're expecting a delivery of goose fat and tin foil and is determined that it won't get through and he'll be saved.
Hey, get back! Get back! Get back! Get back!
Back off!
Get out of here! Get out of here!
Take it back to the depot!
Yes! Yes! Yes.
You're not welcome here! Go on, clear off! Every December, the Archbishop of Canterbury tours the suburbs looking for anyone who he thinks might not have quite understood what Christmas is all about. Oh, I think he spotted one. Snowman down. Fortunately, the blacked-out windows on his SUV mean he and his verger can get away with it without ending up in the Sunday papers. It's Christmas. And there's goodwill to all men, even for burglars. Instead of phoning the police, residents gather round to check the burglar's okay. And invite him in for a nice slice of cake. Don't it make you proud? Music! And of course they're having a merry little Christmas. But one of them is over 4 foot.
What do you want Santa Claus to bring you?
Beer.
Okay.
Beer.
Okay.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight.
Good job.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away. Once again as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who were dear to us will be near. Someday soon we all will be together. If the fates allow. Until then we'll have to move. tunnel through somehow.
Brilliant.
So have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Coming up, it's Davy, and he's stuck in the snow. But tell me, what happens next? Find out after the break on You've Been Framed Christmas Crackers. Welcome back. We left Davy stuck in the snow, but did you guess what would happen next? Well, fortunately, his ex-wife is just up the road, and she's happy to give him a push.
Okay. Davy?
A Land Rover Discovery. Let's hope Davy doesn't discover he didn't renew his insurance. Through Leith's cottage in Mepham, locals believe that the stuff on her roof is icing sugar. Fortunately, at the pull of a lever, Prue can eject them. It's Mary Berry's house that's covered in icing sugar.
And a one.
Who needs 3D printing when we have snow?
I bet.
Ah, the perfect portrait of Jack Nicholson. And now...
Pushing it? No, that was not even far enough.
Olivia Colman. I tried it, but all I got was Greg Wallace. Not everyone's a fan of Winter Watch. This is how he feels about Chris Packham spying on him every night. There has to be an easier way to test if your car alarm is working. Oh! No, try replacing the battery and have another go. It may not be deep, but I think there's just enough there to make a snow angel. Yes, all it needs now is a golden halo. Perfect.
Just peeing right through the head.
I think we all remember our toboggan driving test, don't we? Now execute a three-point turn. Textbook. And finally, an emergency stop. I'm pleased to say, you've passed. All that snow is making me fancy an ice cream. And what goes best with vanilla? No. Chocolate sauce! Merry Christmas! Actually, I've gone off the idea. Grown-ups now. Ah, look, Santa's arrived, or someone dressed as Santa. But Shelby the Labrador is not impressed.
Give me that. Honestly, rubbish. Ho, ho, ho. Forget it.
Zara Larson is thinking about working a new hoverboard routine into her next tour. Oh, Zara. It is your fault, and I do worry about you.
Okay. The rules for Brussels sprout shootout are as follows.
I only wanted to book a hair appointment.
Each of us must take a Brussels sprout. We must place it in between our nether regions. And they're really cold because they're frozen.
Never mind all that. Can you fit my wife in next Tuesday or not?
We have to thrust and try and get it into the bit.
Oh, okay.
We are not allowed to move. Emma, your turn.
Come on, Emma.
Oh.
Oh, forget it. I'll cut her hair myself. I wouldn't mind, but it isn't even Christmas. This was filmed in mid-July. I know her. She works behind the counter in my local pharmacy and sold me something for my chapped lips last week. No wonder my lips are still as dry as a bone and my wife's not talking to me. I think we've all done it. Bored whilst waiting for the dinner to cook, we decide to electrocute the mother-in-law.
Grandpa likes the new socks you guys gave him.
He loves the socks. But he's not so keen on the wood polish Santa put in his stocking.
I guess he's not as good at it as you guys are.
No.
Are you okay, honey?
I think I broke my butt.
Right.
Rick, are you doing that dishwasher, please? All right.
I hate pranks, don't you? Especially the people who play them. Now, Mum, that was your fault, wasn't it? Charming.
Nothing scares him.
He's got a point.
What? Your dad's just dropped all the plates on the floor.
Ah, Britain at play.
Now we have no plates.
Kids now, and that's the tree finished.
Wow. Way to go.
Is that it done?
Is it? Are you so happy now, Kerr?
Yeah,
did you make all your wishes?
Yeah. He has. And wishes come true quickly in this house.
What are you going to ask for?
He wished for a different shaped nose.
Stop this now.
And he got it. What are the rules of foot bottom? I know you kick a ball at your sister's butty. Go! Anything off the top shelf. Take your pick.
What is it?
Looks like Santa ran out of wrapping paper. But no matter, a carrier bag will suffice. Never mind that the oceans are full of plastic. It is Christmas after all.
It's a good one.
On the head, my son. Quick, Dad, get the next carrier bag full of presents out and distract him. Sounds like Christmas around my house. There's always someone crying or whining. But what set them off? It's one of the pixies off the Rice Krispies packet. Now, is that snap, crackle, or sob? It's the turkey's wishbone. But it didn't help the turkey much, did it? If I had a bone in my body I could wish on, I'd wish not to have sage and onions shoved up my backside and be cooked at gas mark 7. Although, I could probably live with the first bit.
Yeah! Oh, Julie got it.
What?
Yeah, Julie got it. And so all her wishes will come true.
No, honey, whoever gets this chuck.
Yes!
Julie had one this
what,
year.
What was my... I wish for a lollipop.
Uh-oh. Looks like that turkey got the last laugh after all. Maybe this was its final wish. To ruin Christmas.
I mean, it's just a little thing.
Merry Christmas.
Mommy lied, didn't she?
It's all lies.
Ow.
And we finish with a Gwen Stefani song. You make it feel like Christmas. There's a reason for that, Gwen. It is Christmas.
Brand new tonight on ITV1, Alison Hammond hits the French Riviera to find out what makes the super rich tick. In at the Rich End is at 9. Next, featuring the voice of Benedict Cumberbatch, it's our animated film comedy, The Grinch.